Thank you for purchasing a Pinnacle 100 cellular and Bluetooth modem development kit for evaluation. In this video, we are going to show you how to verify which out-of-the-box demo firmware is currently loaded to the DVK and how to upgrade to the most current version. Your development kit includes the following: one Pinnacle development board, two M2 screws to secure the modem to the board, two USB Type A to USB Micro Type B cables, one TruePhone MVNO SIM card, which requires activation, one AC adapter with four interchangeable AC interfaces, one external NFC antenna, one BLE sensor board, and one button cell battery. We will begin by installing the layered Pinnacle Connect app from the Google Play or App Store for your mobile device. In this demonstration, we will use this app as one of the ways to connect to the Pinnacle modem and verify the current firmware version, as well as demonstrate upgrading the firmware over the air on modems which have firmware version 3.0 or newer. Next, we will download the firmware images from the GitHub. Navigate to the layered Pinnacle 100 product page at the link provided below. In the Sections drop-down menu, select Documentation. Then select the Software tag. Scroll down to locate the Pinnacle MG100 Out-of-the-Box Applications and Guide GitHub link, and select it. In the far right column of the GitHub page, locate and click on the Releases link to access the most current, fully compiled out-of-the-box demo firmware. Note the Asset Description section to determine which versions to download. The 480.00.0.5.2 firmware is for the Pinnacle 100 DVK. We will be downloading the firmware for both the over-the-air image, or FOTA, and the full image for the LTE-M AWS demo. You will also want to note the command listed here for flashing the image via the SWD JTAG interface. We recommend that you copy and paste this to a text editor for when we perform the upgrade via the JTAG interface. After noting the command, scroll down and click on the links to download the desired firmware versions based on the Asset Description section. You will want to save these files to a location you can access from your mobile device, such as OneDrive, Google Drive, or iCloud Drive. For the purposes of this video, we will not cover attaching the DVK feet or activating and inserting the SIM card. For information on how to perform these tasks, please see the Pinnacle 100 DVK User Guide and the TruePhone SIM Setup Guide application note. You will need to attach the Pinnacle 100 modem to the DVK board by inserting it into the CON1 M.2 interface. Insert the two M.2 screws included in the kit to secure the modem to the board. Ensure the DVK board jumpers and switches are set to the default positions as per the user guide for the Pinnacle 100 development kit. Orient the board as shown, with the module at the top. The board should be configured as shown, with jumpers on J8, J4, J19, and J20. All of the S2 and S5 switches should be to the left. All of the S4 and S3 switches should be to the right. All of the S1 switches should be switched down. Switch 13, the debug select switch, should be set to INT up. Switch 11, the Atmel switch, should be set to on or left. Switch 7, the power source, should be set to USB, far left. And switch 6, power, should be set to on, which is to the left. Insert one end of the USB cables into the FTDI USB port on the DVK and connect the other end of the cable to a USB port on your PC to connect the DVK via the UART. There are a couple of ways to verify which out-of-the-box demo firmware version is loaded on the modem. First, we will verify the firmware version via the UART connection to the module. To do this, we need to open a terminal application such as TerraTerm or PuTTY. These are freely available to download if you do not already have one installed. Open Device Manager to verify the COM port. Open the terminal application and connect to the serial COM port with the following settings. The baud rate should be set to 115.200. Data, 8 bits. Parity, none. Stop, 1 bit. Flow control, none. Press OK to accept the settings. Press the reset button on the DVK to restart the modem and allow it to fully boot up. This may take up to a minute. The version of the out-of-the-box demo firmware will be seen in the output when the device is booting up. If the current version is 3.0 or newer, the firmware can be upgraded via JTAG, UART, or over-the-air using the Pinnacle 100 mobile application. If the current firmware is a version prior to 3.0, it will be necessary to upgrade the firmware over the JTAG interface, as firmware over-the-air updates, or FOTA, were not supported prior to version 3.0. To verify the firmware version using the Pinnacle 100 mobile application, open the Layered Connectivity Pinnacle 100 app that was installed previously on your mobile device. If you have not already done so, create an account and password, and then log in. Click the Find Pinnacle Devices button so the app will start scanning for Pinnacle devices in range. Then select the Pinnacle 100 OOB device from the list of devices shown. Once fully connected, click on Device Information to verify the out-of-the-box demo firmware version. If the firmware version is 3.0 or newer, you can upgrade the firmware over the air using this app. To do this, click the back button to return to the home screen. Click on Device Firmware Update. In the App Version section, under Select Firmware, click the Browse button. The app has defaulted to our OneDrive directory, which is where we saved the image we downloaded previously from the GitHub. By clicking on Files, then OneDrive, followed by Browse, we can back out of the current folder to show its location. From the directory where the image was stored, click on the image file to add it to the Update options in the Pinnacle app. Select this firmware version and then click Update. The file will be uploaded to the modem over the air. This will take approximately 6 minutes. Once the file is fully uploaded, the modem will reset and update the firmware. This will take approximately 2 more minutes. You will see success once the update has completed, and the updated firmware version will be indicated here. You can also go back to the device information to confirm the firmware has been updated to the selected version. As we mentioned when we downloaded the firmware images from GitHub, if the demo firmware loaded to the modem is prior to version 3.0, then the firmware will have to be upgraded via the JTAG interface. To upgrade the firmware over the JTAG interface, we will need to download and install Nordic's NRF command line tools, which are used to flash the hex file to the modem. Navigate to the following link. Scroll down and select Downloads. Select the appropriate platform from the drop-down menu. Then make sure the latest released version is selected and click on the link above to download the selected version. Once the download is completed, navigate to the folder it was downloaded to and run the application as administrator. An installation wizard application will open. Follow the prompts to complete the installation, accepting the terms and conditions of the license agreement. Next, connect the second USB cable to the J-Link interface on the DVK board, and connect the other end to any available USB port on your PC. Right-click the Windows prompt and select Windows PowerShell to open an instance of PowerShell. Enter dir to view the list of directories. Locate the directory where the full hex image was downloaded or saved previously. Note the folder names cannot contain any spaces when working with PowerShell and NRF command line tools. Change the directories in PowerShell using the cd command until you are in the folder where you saved the image. Open the text editor that was used to copy the command from GitHub when we downloaded the firmware images. Modify the command so that it will program the downloaded version. Copy and paste the full command into PowerShell and hit Enter to update the firmware. If you still have the terminal application open, you should see that the firmware version has been upgraded after the modem is reset. This can also be verified with the Pinnacle Connect app by connecting to the modem again and clicking on Device Information. The out-of-box demo firmware has now been upgraded to the most current version. For next steps, navigate back to the Pinnacle MG100 Out-of-Box Demo Applications and Guide GitHub link. Scroll down to the different firmware modes and select LTEM and AWS. Then click the Read Here link for details on how the firmware operates. Additional information, including the datasheet, user guides, application notes, and FAQs, can be found on the Pinnacle 100 product page.